It's where we want to.
Abalunye sura kumi na mbili.
Romans chapter 12.
Nsogele kumi. Ngalume kumi.
Romans chapter 10 from 1. Praise the Lord. These days I got a problem with my throat and they told me to be taking water. Romans chapter 1 and verse 1.
Aboluganda. Tanzania uliyosoma. Aboluganda. Kyenjagala mutima gwange. Era kyensaba Katonda kulwawe kyekino balokoke. Kikubanga mbategeeza nga balina okunyiikirira Katonda naye si mukutegeera. Kikubanga bwe batamanya butuukirivu bwa Katonda era bwe bagezaako okutereeza obutuukirivu bwabwe bo bennyini tebagondera butuukirivu bwa Katonda. Ontegeera oba? Banyiikirira mu Katonda but si mukukola ki?
They struggle in God but not in
understanding. Abanyiikirira baba baweereza.
Those who struggle they are Christians. Praise the Lord.
Era bwe bagezaako okutereeza obutuukirivu bwabwe bo bennyini tebagondera butuukirivu bwa Katonda. Ka mbabuulire okubeera n'ekirabo.
Having a gift is a different thing. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Okubeera n'ekirabo tekitegeeza nti olwo.
To have a gift doesn't mean you have submitted. Yes, I'm an apostle. Praise the Lord.
Ndi pastor.
I'm a pastor.
Ndiyani mpeyona. Ndi evangelist.
I'm evangelist.
Ndi prophet.
I'm a prophet.
Ndikebirabe byokuwonyanga.
I've got gifts of healing.
Ndikebirabe byebyamagero.
I've got gifts of performing miracles.
Ndikebirabe byokuyimba.
I've got a gift of singing.
Wangi.
Praise the Lord.
Ndi intercessor.
I'm an intercessor.
Ebyo byonna.
All of those.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Kyebitegeeza nti olowo ogonda.
Do not mean that you've submitted.
Praise the Lord.
Because all these gifts, God just gave them. He gives them to us. Praise the Lord. I just find myself now like me. I got in a vision seeing a poster before me. Having written what? Paul, an apostle. You also imagine someone who has just conceived. And it came back at the third time. As I saw it march, I went to the pastor. Praise the Lord. I went to pastor. And I asked him, pastor, all the time in my vision I see a very big poster. When it's before my eyes, having very big words. Paul and Apostle, what do they mean? And they blasted me, you don't understand those. I came back thinking maybe I've made a very big mistake. Do you know what it means to be an apostle? Never call it yourself again. What helped me? I never envied my pastor. I did not
stumble.
If at all I had stumbled from him, the problem would have happened there. I say that the apostle is very big.
The pastor has blessed it.
Doesn't it?
the pastor has not understood because he's also a woman. And when the vision comes from God, no pastor has got the capability to stop it. It's only God who touches on that person and says, why don't you leave that person? And doesn't touch on him. For him to touch on him that created that child, it took 2 years. Do you remember the day you heard that
he?
Now understand it today that he is an apostle. And it ended up God telling me, you are an apostle. I remember I heard that you. I remember we had Sebuku. God has told me, you are an apostle. Apostolic is very hard. But it's what God has told me. And I told him, I saw it. And after that, the pastor has brought me back after 2 years. But after that word disappeared, I even had another voice telling me, you also pastor. Now there are two. Only God knows how we do them. That's how visions
come.
That's how ministry comes into where the mama has understood. As the mom of Joseph, the mother never understood, and the father never understood, and even the siblings never understood. It doesn't mean that the vision will go back because they
were not understood.
Even if I'm a pastor, when I've not understood, God cannot change because I've not understood. The vision for your ministry, that's how it came. Nobody can reverse it. But what he's talking about here is
nothing.
He said that they are not submissive to the principles of God.
That's the problem.
So the problem with ministers, we serve,
but it's too following the principles.
But we do not follow God's principles. Praise the Lord. This is the righteousness of God. We have gifts. Say we have gifts. Say we do have gifts. We do have gifts. And in our book, the one we
published,
there are some things there. Praise the Lord. To have gifts, we do have them. But if we to become important in gifts, there must be added a character. How can someone get a character? I'm saying God's character. If he learns to submit for God's principles, it makes him correspond to
the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit builds the nature of Christ in him. Praise the Lord. Someone to be built into a character. It's very painful, not easy. He has to put in some effort to get that gift. Just read Paul and Apostle. It just comes and happens. Praying for the sick and get healed. Being used to make miracles. You do not even know how it happened. You cannot even remember the date.
You know
anything
to get it.
There is nothing. Praise God. But to get the character, to be added onto your gifts, praise the Lord. You put in the effort. You put in some effort, you submit, praise the Lord, you be patient, you leave other things aside, following the principles of God and the
disciples
in many categories. Hello? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So that's why he's saying here, they are very devoted. They are devoted. They fast. They pray. but they don't want to follow God's principles. But their ministers. And you see, it's why this is happening. A church in the whole world is confused in some. Praise the Lord. When we were in Nigeria, the man used this word which always come back to me. He said, praise the Lord.
The church is a problem for Nigeria. For Nigeria.
A kanisa was in Nigeria.
The church is a solution for Nigeria.
I think I'm going to kanisa in
Nigeria.
What would be the answer for the nation?
The problem
has become the problem to the nation.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Even now in Uganda,
and it's really the same here in Uganda. What would be the solution?
The problem.
Right now is the problem.
Well, what is?
That's why the problem is. If you to solve this problem, you go back. The all of the church. Did he just throw it in the world? Never gave it guidance?
No.
No.
I can't say
a church has got guidelines. It has got a Bible. Praise the Lord. He will say it's called Bible. How does he start? How does he
start?
Does he just come from nowhere? That now I'm a pastor? God has called me an apostle. No. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We do not, we didn't just speak
ourselves.
There are some you find and say, God told me. Don't you see madness at a high level? Who were in Masindi, you might not have found people
in this.
I was in Masindi. He has
ever
come here, brought him here. You know, for me, I bring them here, I start watching them. In Masindi. Masindi. He seems to be a strong man, but he has got a very big prophetic gift.
My Lord,
praying for you and remain the same is impossible. The problem, after praying for people, things happen, God is using him. The Holy Spirit continues. He moves away from principles. And when I was here, when they called me to go there, I was here praying. And I understood that man that he's a prophet. Being a prophet, he has got wrong things. I was praying, you as man. I had decided from here that I will not go to that prophet because I've seen the wrong things there happening. I said I will not go. I'm a better of the prophets. He has the gift, but he goes astray from the principles. And then the devil enters. But in gathering people, it's more. It's a and when I reached there, the God spoke with
Mom.
And I told Mom I won't go to Masindi. That man they are telling me to go, I've understood a little of him. I will not go. And Mom said, you know what? God has told me you go. When she said that, I said, let me go. But I knew where I was going. I reached there. Hello? Leave alone these women themselves. There are people with gifts. I reached there. He was a very small man. He put him on a white suit. In a high position. They built something like a There's nobody can step there. He's high in the finger like Jesus. But he has got gifts. I reached him a place. He came down. you know those, you know those people, the prophets, you see each other, but they don't see you before. He sees me while I was also seeing him. He searched for me in spirit when I was also watching. We searched each other. But me, I had already seen him. But he was afraid. The Holy Spirit intervened and touched him and said, that one has no problem. You got my girlfriend. I've been here looking, listening. I've looked into that apostle. He has no problem. And I'm going to welcome him to come and minister. They don't say much. Welcome me. I also got a mic. Their gifts are real. I had really loved that when he was young. You know, for us, we have made 55 years. If I'm a pastor, I'm going to spend 120 years. How many years remaining? Like 65 years. But someone is still in 35. Praise the Lord. I was saying this one will do a great job. And the Holy Spirit said, here in principles is your job. You were receiving to refuse to come, but you had to come. Tell him the principles. He refused them. What will come next is upon him. If he is to obey, he will obey. Submitting to God is righteous. Praise the Lord. If he is to do it, good. We started preaching. And God helped us, the sick got healed. And he really loved the gospel. By the stories you hear, the way you handle marriage is a principle. When you were ministering, the anointing was falling. But when these girls who are jumping, they just think. I told him that's wrong. If you know you're doing it in church, and the Holy Spirit will tell you that here you have in fornication, you have in adultery, you must repent. Whoever is married, go back to your house. Praise the Lord. After that, he said, Apostle, what you said is true. I must repent. I've not been well with my wife. You know, they have Vanilla. And they put a big smile
like that.
A person who gathered the congregation says, I don't have a pastor on
earth.
He called his pastor and they were put together. I've ever brought him here, but he failed to submit. Submission failed. If you've not understood, leave them. But you went there very many times, you cannot come. And all these ministries
hid,
there were and even the people he used to call, they no longer come. Because there was an opportunity to save the gift upon his life, adding on a principle, a character. And don't you ever think that a church like Christ has problems? We've got very many gifts, but the character. If you want to understand
it,
use yourself as an example. Someone steps on you and see how you respond. If someone does, and see what you
utter out,
you know that you is
just
and when you sing, we all get delivered. That's why
you check
has good gifts. These who see girls singing here, and they start vibing them because they're not in the
spirit.
By preaching her home, you will see the character in her. She starts looking at you as you, and you think it's a
light.
You understand? Men preach here on pulpits and anoint
people,
but it takes you home.
He
finds the shoes, he
has
put there when you finish them. You do not touch on his assets, he's like the old men. They are fools, there are many here. And there are many who buy girls. When they are pastors, a wedding is not important. The moment I've left
you,
They are the ones who lead people astray. Do not add there any conversation.
You were a pastor.
And you're
the one who
does
make a
wedding. Interpret his lips with this one and the other
one. It's all rubbish.
The character is walking in the word. If it's marriage, if it follows you to 100,
what you can say,
whether you will man
or woman,
I don't
refuse
that. But you must behave as the Lord. If you are not in fellowship, there's nothing you can do. Even if a pastor
was anointing,
you cannot train a minister and to produce what he has to do until you are in one accord.
I don't know that you got me right.
That's the scripture.
Pastor,